Good evening, friends. In today's discussion, I will explain how an age-old vampire story can also be told differently at many levels. How characters can be used to communicate a lot more than just showing killings in excessive use of VFX. For example, it's different. That's true. I'm not doing the advertisement for free, but VWatch on Netflix is super different. Movie Shubhi viewers, you need to have some background of this web series before we start the charcha today. So on the story, I will tell you as much that is shown in the VWatch trailer. We don't have to be the spoilers here. Story is about an incident where few scientists who work for government on various projects and projects for good, not some US Area 51 kinds experimenting on aliens. They somehow get infected with the rare virus, and the virus can turn people into vampires of various kinds. And that's an interesting turn, vampires of various kinds? That's unheard. Talking about the characters in this series, there are three main characters. Lead one by Ian Somerhalder. He is shown as a bright scientist. Lead by Adrian Holmes. He gets infected for what happened to him. Please see the series. The connection between the two is almost like brothers. They don't call them friends, they call them real brothers. Lead three in the background of series one, I would say, is Calyx, played by Peter Outbridge. And he's a notorious man. Guys, there is a deeper and a different take. It's something that we haven't seen before. To get into the insights for this series, I will adapt a very different style today. A lot of questions that will raise your interest level. That way I'll be true to my promise of not revealing the story that much and do a genuine friendly charcha and a discussion with you. So what are the questions? Question number one. What truly triggers the change in humans to become a vampire? Are all vampires bad? Can you connect with a vampire on emotional grounds? Can you have sympathy with them? I mean, how do you feel about killing humans at the night when you have to feed yourself for hunger, but your true nature is of a human, because before getting infected with the virus, you were actually a human. Is there any emotional trauma with vampires, or will they become unreasonable because they have to now kill and feed themselves? Or can you have a conversation with them and bargain with them when they have a bloodlust? What is an alternative to their bloodlust? Can they survive with humans, or will there be a war? With so much connection between Luther and Michael, will it anchor some kind of a harmony? Which race will win? Humans or vampires, or both? Will they coexist? See, you are already eager to see the series. Keep your eagerness alive. I think there is a part 2 in the making as well. Wait. Ruko. Different script ke baare mein baat ho rahi hai. To kal aane wala hai ek aur different kahani ka charcha. Samantar, which is released on MX Player. It's a very, very different story again. Subscribe karna mat bhulna.